Good morning, everyone. Before getting to the core of this workshop, I would like to thank you all for coming today. And I would like also to thank Justine Praneuf, who has been organizing this workshop on all the practical aspects of the bookings of your hotel, etc., as well as Guilhem Sorel, who is our photographer today and who is coping with all the technical aspects for the conference. So thanks to them also. So now, wording robotic, what this is all about. I have to thank my directors to that they have gathered all of you specialists in the problematics that I'm exploring within my research. As you may know, I'm a PhD candidate in both the Free University of Brussels and the National Institute of Applied Science in Toulouse. And I work here at the LAS within the team GPTO, which is specialized in motion of anthropomorphic systems. Now I will not present to you my plan of work because first it's too incomplete. But mainly because as an introduction of this workshop, I find it more interesting to share with you the general questions that I'm considering within my research. So my research began with an observation. As humans challenge their expectations about robots, they wish to gain a better understanding of the field of robotics. And for this purpose, and regardless of whether they are the visitors of a lab, the audience of a conference, some citizens, some journalists, or even the European Parliament, the first steps consist in consulting the expert in the field. Indeed, the roboticists seem to be in the best position to guide the society in this matter, whether it is in the everyday life or within an official institution. Unfortunately, the dialogue between the public and the roboticist is not always efficient. And there is a gap between how robotics is perceived by the public and robotics as it is actually practiced. And this gap is especially obvious when we compare the sources of wonder of the public and the ones of roboticists when facing moving machines. So those moving machines that take decision, show some autonomy, follow learning process, and we even sometimes talk about intelligent systems. But what do we mean by that? Are these words some rhetorical figures, or should we consider them in a literal meaning? We are also questioning if those words are not too ambiguous. And the question is, should we ban them from the natural language? Do they reflect a naive or irrational, or at least naive projection of intention on an artifact? So there exist multiple reasons for the human brain to project intention on an artifact. The shape of the object, so we talk about anthropomorphism, the context in which this object is discovered, the habit of interacting with the artifact, and within the physical space, movement is a necessary condition for the human brain to project intention and intelligence on an object, even though every robot motion doesn't implicate a projection of intentionality on an artifact. Indeed, there are some criteria that I'm still exploring, as the repetition of movement, the ability to understand the action. Those criteria have a role in how human attributes intention to others. Also, every robot action does not lead human to perceive the artifact as being actually endowed with will and intelligence, etc. So, for example, an automatic vacuum cleaner can be spontaneously seen as a crab and you can feel amused or uncomfortable with it. we will naturally say that the robot decides to go on the left of the bed. But this word will not create any ambiguity and eventually manifestation to free robots or official meetings to settle robots' rights, because nobody is going to actually read this verb literally. So what is the relation between robots' motion and actions, projection of intentionality, and the lexicon, the rhetorical figures, the words used to describe robots? Which situation implicating robots raise a doubt on how to interpret this word? Also, another question I'm asking is it different to vulnerable people and children than to others, as it is suggested in the report adopted by the European Parliament with recommendation on civil law rules on robotics? Is it different for roboticists? Whether we are roboticists or a general audience, we all use this set of words to describe robots' action. Last week, I heard a roboticist saying that HRP2 was not bothered by you pushing his leg like a doctor would do on a patient. But if the audience doubts about the status of these words used in robotics, it could be explained by the fact that the general audience adopts the intentional stance, while the roboticists use the design stance. The intentional stance allows to predict other agents' action by assuming that they are pursuing goals. And this word was coined by Daniel Dennett. On the other hand, the design stance allows to predict other agents' behavior based on how they are designed and not through a projection of intentionality on the agent. So for example, we know that birds are designed to fly, so we assume it will act in accordance with this design when we release it. So in this case, the question is, do roboticists inhibit the intentional stance? And if yes, how? Can it explain why they are not enchanted by robots' action that the general audience find incredible? And in the contrary, can it explain why roboticists find some robots' motion wonderful while the audience see just obviousness? So now, as a conclusion, in the first part of my research, I intend to propose another understanding of these words than as misuses of language. I will expose an alternative point of view that fits to a naturalistic conception of language and rationality. So rather than optical illusions that conduct to irrational or naive interpretation, I believe that the semantic attribution should be seen as a rational cognitive strategy in order to capture our environment. And in the second part of my research, I intend to better understand the functioning of these words and to describe it. So I will explore the bond between the rhetorical figures and the robotic motions and actions, while taking into account the impact of the intentional and the design stance. To do so, I will observe the way roboticists use the lexicon. Do they always use these words as rhetorical figures, as images, as they pretend? Secondly, I will test the roboticists in order to discover how they deal with the intentional and the design stance when they face robots' motions and actions. Here are a very, very small list of my references, and thank you for your attention. I hope you're gonna enjoy this workshop, and I leave the floor again to Jean-Paul.